It might not be for you, then again, we don't even know who this one is for in the first place.
We'll see. When CNN's Jeannie Wells heard about a music contest, she couldn't believe her ears. Maybe you won't believe yours either after this from Mostly New York. Maybe you think this band is bad. But just bad isn't good enough. Spin Magazine is looking for the worst.
Yeah, we're looking for some loser in his bedroom that stumbled on Genius.
Spin asked his readers to send in their wretched entries to the worst band contest.
I hate stuff that sounds like that.
You'd be testy, too, if you had a box full of bad music to listen to. Audio tapes, video tapes, even a record or two. And the bands all have weird names.
These are the psychic British gorillas.
Angry at the microwave.
BOS stands for buckets of
Some bands like to introduce themselves.
And we're Beans for Supper.
Beans for Supper? Why, they sound undernourished. What is that tapping?
With the Christmas.
You're also out of the running if you're not bad enough, fast enough. The judges can only bear to listen to about 5 seconds of each entry. The rejects in the worst band contest are treated with the respect they deserve. The entries come packaged in everything from newspaper ads to cereal boxes.
This sort of thing really helps.
A stuffed duck with a band's name on it.
That is disgusting.
A spoiled bologna sandwich. The contest winner gets $500 and some exposure. But what's it like to earn the title Worst Band?
It was like winning, like, the dating game or something.
James Garcia and Frank Palestra are the two remaining members of the previous Worst Band winner, a Miami group called Scraping Teeth. Out on the street, we played a tune of theirs called Choke the Turkey. Despite winning the contest in 1992, Scraping Teeth is not even scraping by. They keep losing their bass player. How bad are they?
For the most part, everybody would leave the club until we finish playing.
The band's own video proves its ability to drive away an audience. Listening to worst band contestants takes a toll on the judges. They reject. They reflect. They get bored. They get bummed out. So what are they looking for?
The heifers, crazy baby. This is more like it.
My mother would like it.
Yep.
Mom? How you doing, Ma? I want to play you something.
How do you like it now, Mom?
The beginning was horrible.
Yep.
But I'm glad I don't have to dance to it.
I'll call you later. And then there was the entry no one wanted to open because it was covered with some sort of fungus or mold.
Thank you, Dan. Well, we could stand and watch while you opened it. I don't think we should open it.
Obviously, we should open it because we're the ones with the judgment.
But is it that you don't want to touch it?
I don't want to touch it.
Yeah, we ended up taking the infected entry out on the sidewalk where a Spin magazine staffer had the guts to cut it open.
I think we have a winner.
For worst packaging, if not worst band. Look, it's in perfect condition. But the guitar probably isn't. This is a band called Mazoon. We took their music to the street. This lady actually moved closer.
That's one of them.
That's not part of the music.
It's torture. That's S&M. That's bad.
That just has no something.
Please don't send any more entries. The contest is closed. Eventually, they'll announce the losers who end up winning.
The first song is called Boy with Breast Implants.
He was a boy with breast implants. He was a boy with breast implants.
If you can tap your toes to it, it's out. Demo CNN, New York.
Well, you can hum in the shower and feel pretty good about it now. That's it for our Friday edition of CNN Morning News. Good to have you join us. I'm Donna Kelly.
I'm Phil Leon Harris, and Joe Bishop Day is coming up next. And here's Lauren Sidney in New York with a preview.